send him to the bench. I don't lost what I'm speaking. I'm gone down. Ready, said, don't hit too low. No, I need my legs. Coach, please sit him. Young dog can't catch. Send him to the bench. I don't lost what I'm speaking. I'm gone.
It's Madden NFL 22 on EA Sports, and we've got a showdown in the AFC East. It's the Bills and the reigning AFC champs on EA Sports.
From the stadium that hosted Super Bowl 48 back in 2014, there's a look at MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford. A few minutes ago, the hometown Jets were introduced to this sellout crowd, and it's a roar that could be heard across the river in Manhattan. They're set to go as their Jets will match up with the Buffalo Bills. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Throwing on first down, Cobb. And he will find Davis, that's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says, our guy is better than your guy's. Because, you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. He's going to be involved multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time. And now it's third down. They'll look to throw again. And going deep for Hill. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way you wanted to start this ball game as it brings up fourth down. Here's Jack Fox on to punt. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And 9 yards there on the return following a punt of 47. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that, Tony, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere like that.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
Oh, Hill, great grab. Touchdown, Jets. Tyreek Hill, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jets have made this a one-score game. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace?
So this offense will head back out there, already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. On first down, Hines, a good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
He could muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a third and very short. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. 2 minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this second week of the regular season. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He'll check this down to Hines. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Here's Hines. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11.
I like this focus there because he wasn't thinking about breaking that one big. All he thought about was, I need one. Let's go get that. Ended up picking up two.
On first and 10, Cobb. This to Hines on the drop off. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. To throw on second down, Cobb. And he's got it. And he's brought down.
Make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys that we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
A final shot before break. Cobb got a man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Elijah Moore, as time expires in the first half. And the Jets have taken the lead on the final play of the first half. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Hey, Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34. Big yardage that time for the Jets.
It doesn't look like this defense found the magic elixir at halftime. This offense was rolling in the first half, and that's continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
And a short gain down to about the 33. Give him maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. They run again with Hines. And not much running room. Down to the 32. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. A.J. Epinesa with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of 7. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. And this score will stay right. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time? Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Now a pass that's taken in by Hill.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass. Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. And we'll get a moment here as they look this one over.
Yeah, remember now, the call on the field is what they'll stick with unless they have clear video evidence to the contrary. And I give these officials a lot of credit. Such a tough and demanding job. You and I both know that. Yeah, they make the right call way more often than they get it wrong.
So the decision to challenge does not pan out, and that's also going to cost him a timeout. On third down, it's Hines, and he gets this one across midfield for the first down to the 46.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Tackle made there by Matt Milano. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Looking to throw, Cobb. He'll get this one complete to Davis. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 29-yard line.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Well,
they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Now a throw here, hauled in. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Back now here on EA Sports. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. On second down now, it's Hines. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Elijah Moore, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Jets have taken the lead. A plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here, and they were able to do so.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. They'll start on the ground with Hines. A gain of 3, second down.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Looking to throw on second down. Cobb. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4, second and 6. Coming up on a second and 6. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hines. And he's taken down inside the 30. 57 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
But they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there. Gave up another first down. They have all 3 timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you guys start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you, at what point you think now's the go time?
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Well, clear running situation. Try to take time off the clock. You ran the previous play, set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they had shown the ability to run the football. So now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit them over the top.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. And to give this time to the tailback. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. A great effort there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Jets find a way to stretch their lead. And that's certainly going to bump up. So this offense will head back out there, already in excellent field position thanks to the interception. On first down, Cobb. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. The sack recorded. It's a loss of 5, and now it's second down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. They'll keep it on the ground. Hines. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Naeem Hines, the second touchdown on the season. And the Jets capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6.
Things are rocking easy here in the fourth.
So now we're in the final minute of the game in the fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over. The Jets, with victory seemingly in hand, they take a knee. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. And they will take a knee here. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. The Jets, with victory seemingly in hand, they take the knee. Good bounce back win. They take the knee. Can't stop the clock defensively. Tough opening week loss, but now 1-1.
Shows that they handled things really well. A lot of teams panic after a week one loss and they start to think that the sky's falling. This team realized there's a long season and they feel very talented and they get it done in this one.
Charles, in this one, I think the storyline really in the fourth quarter, coming into it neck and neck, but they were able to separate, put their foot on the gas, and get the win.
And since you mentioned neck and neck, I'm going to stay with a little bit of a horse racing theme. It was that close, and then really went into the gallop and finished it strong.
One more horse racing theme.
Go.
I am glad you posted today.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
So for the Jets, they make amends for their week one loss by winning their home opener. And they'll get another home date next week as the Raiders will come to town. Meanwhile, for Buffalo, they will fall to 1-1. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Houston Texans.